Hi guys, and welcome to another Vlogmas. So today I'm going to be showing you Smokey's winter morning routine. To go down to the yard. It's still dark, so apologies for the lighting. I do however have my light up Christmas jumper all ready to go to see in the dark. But before we head down to the yard, I just wanted to say I hope you all are enjoying Vlogmas. Let me know in the comments below if you are, and don't forget to enter my giveaway to win a cap. Right, let's jump into the video. So the first thing that I do every single morning is go and check on Smokey, check he's okay, see if he's had a good night, and I either ride him straight away or I turn him out and then ride later. During winter I'm increasingly riding him straight out of the stable just to make it more efficient for myself. So I always bring him a hay net if I am riding him straight away to keep him occupied while I give him a groom. So I quickly changed his rug over to his Thermotex. He was in his turnout rug because he was originally due to go straight out into the field. So I just put his Thermotex on to keep him warm while I give him a groom and pick out his hooves. Come on, pick it up. So then it's on to giving him a good old brush. So his tail at the moment is looking particularly dirty, but that is the reality of owning a grey in winter, unfortunately. Smokey enjoys laying down in the stable all the time. He enjoys a good old roll in the field, so keeping him clean is literally a full-time job. And I only tend to give him like a quick groom in the morning, just because I'm normally in a rush to, you know, get the day started. So that's his tail done, and then we'll go and detangle that mane.
Keep him warm.
And I am aware that Smokey's mane is in dire need of cutting, but my mum's stolen my hair scissors. We have like professional scissors to do their manes and things, and my solo comb has also gone missing, so I'm thinking that's mum. And Smokey's mane does grow at the speed of light. I am constantly cutting it. So then I give him a little bit of a brush off with the magic brush. This tends to be just his legs, any areas he's been laid down and has like dried poo or mud or anything like that. And then I would normally go over his body with the body brush, but he had a really good like groom the night before this, so I just did the little dirty areas that I could see. And then it's my turn to get ready, so I always put my boots on and put my hat on before I start tacking up so that I'm all ready to go. And these are my Treadstep Island boots. I must have had these for about 3-4 years now. I absolutely love them. I am getting to the point where I'm going to need some new riding boots, and I'm absolutely dreading getting rid of these. So then I head to the tack room and I grab Smokey's tack. And then it's time to tack up. So if I ride out, I put an exercise sheet on him. Even though he's fully clipped, I don't tend to if I ride him in the school. I have ordered him another one for riding the school because his one that I ride out in is reflective. So today we're just putting the normal tack on. Saddle, martingale, bridle is his normal attire.
And he's such a good boy, he puts his own bit in for me. He's probably the easiest of all seven of my horses to tack up. He basically does it for you. And I've had this bridle for a little while now. It's the GFS Grackle. And I think it was literally like £45 or something like that. And it is one of the nicest bridles I think I've ever had. I absolutely love this. So if you are looking for a really, you know, non-expensive bridle that looks really nice and it fits him really well, it goes so much better in a Grackle. And then it's off into the arena. So today we're going to be working in the smaller flat work arena because we're not doing any jumping. As you can see from the ground, it was frosty, but I'm very lucky that our arenas don't freeze. They are very good all-weather arenas, so unless it is absolutely like minus temperatures, we can generally ride in them most of the time. So I just go and jump on, and today we're just going to be doing a bit of flat work. Smokey is still feeling very fresh at the minute. This video wasn't long after his clip, so he is feeling rather fresh and rather forward, as you can tell from his little head bobs. It's like, let's go, Mum. So I just start with a gentle warm up, especially on cold days. I don't want to be rushing to wake up those muscles, not forgetting he has also been stood in the stable, so he hasn't moved around a lot, so he can be a little bit stiff first thing. So we just do lots and lots of walking, which I will obviously skip over for you guys because it's not that interesting. So then we start trotting, and Smokey was actually really good this morning. Sometimes, first thing, there are obviously horses being turned out, people mucking out, so you can be a bit like, oh, what's happening over there, what's happening over there. But I actually find when he is quite forward and he is quite fresh, he's actually very responsive and listens to me really well. So that is definitely a plus side of him being a bit more on the forward side at the moment. And it was an absolutely beautiful morning. I really love these crisp sort of winter mornings where, yeah, it's cold and you can see your breath, but the sun is shining, the sky is blue. It was just really beautiful to ride in this morning. So once we've warmed up in our walk and our trot, it's then on to some canter work. So you'll see I'm working on Smokey's left rein canter a lot at the moment, and that's because this is his worst canter. What we've been doing is just to ask him to do more of an inside bend, because he tends to do outside flexion on the left rein. Is we've been working on a lot of circles with him, doing expanding circles, so going from a 20 meter, spiraling in, spiraling out, getting him to really bend to the inside. It's always been his worst rein, has his left, and it's something that the physio's picked up that he is a little bit tighter on, so we're doing a lot of work on that. I do like to use the opportunity in the morning once he's warmed up to have a good old canter, get the blood flowing, get some energy off him, especially if the ground is frozen, because then he's less likely to go and, you know, canter around the field. And so that's it for our morning session. Not too much today. We were in for about half an hour, which is quite a nice amount of time for Smokey at the minute. He is still obviously recovering from colic and everything. We're not 100% there yet. So once we are, he will then be back to his full 45 minutes. So then I just quickly untack. I always find this part like really boring. I don't know why. It's like I've watched people put the tack on. I don't need to watch you take it off. So I've just quickly sped that up. And obviously I pop his Thermotex on straight away because, as I said, it was pretty cold this morning. And then I just give him a brush off. Now I'm just using a finishing brush on him. I don't tend to need anything else. He hadn't sweated up or anything like that. And then it's time to rug up for the field. So Smokey has now gone to his heavyweight rug for turning out. So this is his Weatherbeater heavyweight. Absolutely love this rug. It's probably one of my favourites. It fits him really lovely. The neck cover's nice and loose so it doesn't rub on their mane. And it is nice and heavy so it keeps him lovely and warm during these cold winter days. So then it's time for Smokey's favourite part of the day, and that is heading out to the field. He absolutely loves being turned out in the morning, so I just go and pop his head collar on. I have no idea why I decided this morning to put it over his ears. I never do that. I always like do the top buckle, but I obviously was feeling lazy. And because he was such a good boy this morning, I obviously had to go and get him some treats. So he just popped into my little like storage section and grabbed some treats out for him.
Whoa. Don't be jumpy when you're in here, there's not enough room. Right, come on.
So good job you're only little, because you do put yourself in some silly positions.
And then off we head to Smokey's paddock. So by this point the frost had actually pretty much lifted because the sun was out, which was really nice, and it started to warm up. So I just let Smokes off, and you can see I just picked up a little bit of some sugar beet. So on the farm they have like loads of sugar beet that if you want to give your horses you can. Smokey gets a little bit as a treat every now and again. So I just gave him that this morning as his little morning treat. And then normally he would canter down the field, but as I said, we did plenty of canter work this morning. So he wasn't that fussed, he just went for a little stroll down. And now on to mucking out. So I stick on my Lemire yard gloves. These are honestly such lifesavers in winter because they're nice and warm and they are waterproof, which is really handy if you're breaking ice on troughs or anything like that. And all of my equipment is from Red Gorilla. So a huge thank you to Red Gorilla for providing these products and for sponsoring this video today. I'll go through everything I use. So this is my very much well loved, as you can probably tell by the color of it, Big Tidy. I've actually had this over a year and it is fantastic. The little fork is fully plastic. And when I first got it, I was like, oh, I don't know if that will, you know, be as durable as the traditional metal ones, but it's so good, and as I say, it's lasted me a full year so far without any problems, so they're definitely perfectly durable. And the first thing I do is I go in with my Big Tidy and just scrape up all of the poo. I find doing it like this instead of, you know, using a fork to remove poo saves me a lot on shavings and also makes it quite more efficient. I find it a lot easier than like just chucking up loads of shavings. And I'm just popping all of this into my Red Gorilla wheelbarrow, which again is fantastic. I really like the sort of shape of the wheelbarrow. I know that sounds daft, but everyone has a personal preference. But that is definitely one of my favourite items from Red Gorilla as well. And then it's on to sifting through the wet. And chucking up the bedding to make sure I've not forgotten any bits of poo, because obviously Smokey tends to walk his bed in, so sometimes you can. So this is the PC bedding fork. Again, this is the plastic variety. I do also have the Riddler. I'm currently favouring my plastic one. Again, I've had this for over a year and it has lasted me really, really well. It's absolutely perfect for getting out wet and for chucking up your shavings bed. And sometimes I use this to poo pick in the summer when the ground's a lot drier. But during the winter, I use my Big Tidy because it's a bit easier if, you know, like it's frozen or anything like that. So as you can see, Smokey did a really good job of walking his bed everywhere this morning, and he is due a shavings upgrade, so I gave him a really good deep clean out today. I chucked out a lot more than I normally would, so about once a week I'll give him a really, really good deep clean out, and that means today I'm going to be leaving his bed up. So what I do is I brush all of the clean shavings that he's knocked to the front of his stable. I brush those back using my Gorilla broom. So this is the 30 centimeter head. I find this one's really good for inside the stable because it's a bit smaller, so you can get into those nooks and crannies. I do also have the larger head, but I mainly use like on the yard and things. So once all of the dry, clean bedding has been brushed into the banks, I then go over the wet patches and brush up any of the wet and remove that. And as I said, I will be leaving his bed up like this today. So I leave the banks up to allow the middle to dry. Because it is a warmer winter day, I always try and do this on warm days because obviously it's not going to dry if it's cold. And then I go and empty my wheelbarrow onto the muck heap. So I'm really lucky at my yard. There's a muck trailer literally at the end of the stables. So I just empty that on and then scoop it all up to make sure that there's plenty of room for everyone else. So the final step of my morning routine is to take down the two hay nets that Smokey has on an evening, and I'm going to be filling these with some new hay. So Smokey is still on increased roughage since his colic, because obviously we're still wanting him to have plenty and plenty of forage, and a little bit more than he normally would, just to help shift his gut, keep that moving, and he is going to be on psyllium once a month. He wasn't on psyllium at this point, which is why he's not had a feed, but that is the reason that he is on extra forage at the moment. So I just very quickly, if only it was this quick in real life, fill the two hay nets, and I fill these full, like I make sure that you can't really get any more hay in there, so they are nice and heavy and they will last him the entire evening. And so finally, I just go and tie this up in his stable. So I'll pop his bed down and put new shavings in later this afternoon when I come to see to him.
So guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you have enjoyed it. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on the bell icon so you get a notification every single time I post. I will see you in 2 days' time. See you all soon, guys. Bye.